born in 1902. He was born in the Oak Park. He was died in the year February 4, 1987. The nationality is basically from America. His field of work is psychology. And he was the alumni of the University of Wisconsin-Madison, as well as did some of the colleges also did his courses. And what his own contributions, known contribution to the entire world is the person-centered approach. Therefore, it is commended the humanistic approach because he is much concerned the human, internal and external factors it may be involved in. And he find that there is an internal and external effect may be the people personality. And other contribution like the client-centered therapy, student-centered learning, as well as the Rogerian arguments. So this is the three things and the notable contribution from his end. His theory, he made the theory in the name of person-centered therapy. Person-centered theory also. He was the humanist psychologist, I already mentioned that. He agreed with the main assumption of Abraham Lincoln. So he accepted all the assumptions made by the Abraham Lincoln. However, the Rogers know, he added that for the persons to grow, they need an environment that provides them with genuineness as well as the acceptance and the empathy. For the growth of the people, or if you want to reach the self-actualizations, we have to keep the three things according to him. One is called genuineness. The second one is called acceptance. In the case of the acceptance, he's talking about the two acceptance. One is called unconditional love. Other one is called conditional love. Those are having the unconditional love, then the people's only, they may be reaching self-actualization according to him. And the third one is the empathy. So the growth of the persons may depends on the three things. One is called genuineness of the people. Then the conditional love, that is called the acceptance. There, unconditional love only is talking here. And the third one is called empathy. The three things only decide the people's growth, according to the Carl Rogers. And he viewed the personality structure in terms of the self-concept, because each one having his own self-concept. And he believes that one's that self-concept made based on the one's own behavior, his nature, as well as the qualities. Even for each of us, we have some kind of self-analysis. So from the self-analysis, that is called SWOT analysis. From the SWOT analysis, we can know that who we are. So we know our positive, we know our negative and all. Sometimes we are thinking about much about our positive. Even that, superiority complex. Some people have a lot of superiority complex. Some people are inferiority complex. It also may affect the people's personality, according to the Carl Rogers. And he highlighted that one more thing, an important tool in the human, particularly the human acceleration, is the development of the image of oneself. Here he mentioned the two kinds of self. One is called real self, other one is called the ideal self. So there is a two different selves he is introducing here. That also I am going to be list out here. What is the exact difference between the two? And see this image, when you're discussing about the humanistic approach, I already mentioned that there is an internal and external factor may affect the personality of the people according to the humanistic psychology. The same thing, the individual is called internal, individual motivations. It may make the use of the people's personality. And one more factor that's called environment, that's called external factor. Therefore, the internal factor of individual, the environment is an external factor. Altogether, it made the people's personality. So this is the same theory only, this is the same things only decided by the Carl Rogers. A person reacts to change in the phenomenal field, which includes the external objects and people as well as the internal thoughts and the emotions. See, in the lot of manner, the internal as well as the external facts may influence. For example, objects. Some people may make our personalities, our thoughts, our self-images, even our behavior. Everything's based on these things only, our self may decide. Our self is nothing but our personality. So this is the main part of the theory of the Carl Rogers. And the fundamental field refers a person subject to reality. And also, his theory is totally based on the observation, only the subjective based only. He's not doing the deep research in this. Based on the subjective reality, he made this particular theory. The subjective reality, which includes external objects and people, as well as the internal thoughts and the emotions. The personal motivations and environment both act on the fundamental field. So this is called as a fundamental field. So the entire circle, no, the center part. So this is a field. From this only, we are finding that whom you are. That is called our personality. We find out from this kind of factors only. So in this case, individuals represent the internal factors. That is called our internal motivations. The environmental is a factor, is called as an external factors. Like we are learning everything through this only, like people, sometimes the some objects, it may be affect our personality also. And see, he mentioned here, the humanist approach stated that the self is composed with the concept. Suppose some people are talking about the self concept, how the self concepts may generate in the sense based on the three domains only. So based on the three things only, three components only, our self-concept may describe. The self-concept is a three components or company of the three. One is called self-worth. Second one is called self-image. The third one is called ideal self. Sometimes we may tell us the self-image is a real image. This is called as an ideal image. So there is a difference among the three. Just I'm going to list all the difference among the three one by one. See, the first one is a self-worth. So all together, all the three together only is called as a self-concept. In this case, self-worth is described as here. What we think about ourselves, this term is important. So the self-worth, we have some kind of pre-notion that what we think about ourselves. So that pre-notions we have, no? We think, who am I? So that thought, that thinking is called as here self-worth. But in the case of self-image, how we see yourself, how we see ourselves. So that is called thinking. Here is talking about think. But here talking about how you see you. So sometimes we have the picture that I'm very strong boy. I'm very colorful. Like that we have some kind of, thoughts or some kind of perception we have, no? Based on our physical appearance. So that it may talking about the how we see, that's for self-image. But don't think this is only the physical appearance, it may involve to the our in the entire personality. And the third one is called ideal self. The ideal self is look like our imagination. So you have some kind of ambitions. That ambitions I become a prime minister, like that I have the thought in the sense that it should be an ideal self. So this is a person who we would like to be. So we have some kind of ambition to reach, you know, that ambition, that goal or that thought, you know, that thought is called as the ideal self. So these three things combination only is called as self-concept. The three things only decide the people's self-concept. But here, generally in the self-concept, we may treat it in two self-concept. One is called a positive self-concept or one is a negative self-concept. So in the case of the positive self-concept, if the person have the positive self-concept, they tend to feel good about who they are and often see the world as a safe and a positive place. They may feel like that. But suppose if the people are having the negative self-concept, they may feel unhappy because normally they won't comfortable because they have the negative thoughts. And they are particularly the negative self-concept, they always say a pessimist, not an optimist also. They may feel unhappy with who they are. So in this manner, we can easy to find the whole, because our thought only decide what kind of personality we are. Just one second, I'm going to highlight what is the self-worth. The self-worth represent here what we think about yourself or ourselves. So according to the Rogers, he blew that this kind of self-worth may develop during the childhood days itself. How it will develop in the sense based on the interaction with the fathers and mothers. Based on the interaction with the father and mother, this kind of thoughts, this kind of self-worth may develop from them. And the self-image, how we see ourselves. So generally the self-image includes our body image on inner personality. So we have, we can connect with, we already talking about, no, there is association between the our body as well as the our personality. So there's some kind of, we have the strong notion about our what is the body as well as the personality things. So it may influence both. As a simple level, we might perceive, this is a small example I'm listed here, perceive ourselves as a good or bad person or beautiful, ugly. So I feel that I'm very good. Okay, sometimes I'm not good. So based on the situation, only we may find whether we are good or not. But generally, we have some somewhat pre-idea that I look like this only. That thought is called a self-image. That is called a self-image. And self-image has been effect on how the person thinks, feels, behaves in this world. So in this self-image, may connect with the person thinking, how he feels, and how he behaves in the external world. In the case of the ideal self, I already mentioned, it's like a goal or ambitions. It consists of our goals and ambitions in the life. And this thing should be dynamic, it's not be a static one. Suppose I want to become a UGC chairman. Then within 10 months, I may feel that I want to become a Indian Prime Minister. So like that, we have the different ambitions, no? That ambitions always is not a static, it's maybe a dynamic one. It may be changing also. The ideal self, the childhood it's not developed in the childhood. It may develop in the, particularly in the teenage time only. And these two things only, particularly the self-image and ideal self only, divides the personality of the people much. And just once again, I'm going to focus on the self-concept. The self-concept, I already mentioned that the three components may involve in self-concept. One is called self-worth, then second one is called ideal self, then third one is called self-image. But here, I already mentioned the positive tense, because the self-concept is the 2N, positive N, as well as the negative. So the people having the positive self-concept, negative self-concept. But what is the difference between the positive self-concept and negative self-concept here in the sense? And the positive self-concept people, they act, feel, thinking, everything should be optimistic. And they are constructive people also. But in the case of negative, their act, feel, and thinking is replicated, everything is pessimistically. And they are very destructive thoughts people suffer. And the self-concept, there's two kinds of self. That is called ideal self as well as the real self. So these two things only decide the people's self-concept. So in this case, ideal self means what you are believing, what you believe, what your hopes. So what your hopes in the future, what is your wishes, that is called the ideal self. But in the case of real self, is based on the actual experience. For example, I am having the, what is this? I am not moved to the six-pack people and all, because I am having the for stomach and all. Suppose I like to go with, so the real self, based on my actual experience, if I go for 1 month gym also, I could not be convert my body to a six pack, right? So if you have that kind of real self, it's not at all, because I'm having a very big belly now. So therefore the real self is the actual experience, what you are. So what really is ourself, that is called real self. But I have the ideal self, I believe that within very soon, otherwise I may reach the six pack very soon. Otherwise today itself or tomorrow itself, I may go for six pack. Like this, based on our hopes and wishes. So I'm thinking that I want to develop a six pack within tomorrow. So how we'd like to see ourselves? That is called ideal self. There is a lot of mismatch, because I am having very big belly. How within a day or within a 1 month, how can translate, how may convert as a six pack? It's not be possible. So that it leads to some kind of frustration. That frustration.
Excuse me, sir. Sorry to interrupt, but I have a question. Yes. Like, can we call positive self concept people as self obsessed? Can we say that?
No. Here, each one's having this idea, because the positive self-concept, negative concept, we can divide the people like this. But each one having the ideal self versus the real self, for each one of us here. You got clear? So here, each one, for us, every people having the ideal self as well as the real self. Suppose that, what is that? If the ideal self is much compared to the real self, we have some kind of personal disorders may come. Because you could not be competent with the ideal self with the real self, because the real self, what you are now. I hope you are
I was asking about the positive self concept and negative self concept. Real and ideal, I understood that one. Okay. But my question is, can we call positive self concept people, like you said, they are very optimistic and they feel good about themselves. So can we call them as self-obsessed people or self-centered people?
Yeah, of course. There is a tool, no? You can see this lot of psychological tools related to self-concept. That tools, those are gaining more mark. For example, if I give the 50th statement, it's measuring the self-concept. Those are gaining much mark in the self-concept. They are called as CA positive self-concept people. Those who are getting lower score, they may treat it as a negative self-concept. Those who are getting to the normal marks, like average mark, they're called as a moderate self-concept. So we can easy to categorize the any personality, any kind of the self-concept or self-esteem into the three ends. One is called positive end, negative end, parallel the moderated end also. So we can divide it. That's not at all issue. So all the psychology tool, if you look onto the some of the, even you can Google it, self-concept tools, self-concept or self-esteem, you can find out the lot of tools, but apparently they may give the interpretation like this. There is a interpretation also, basically the statistically I'm telling. The statistically we can divide any group with the use of the mean and standard deviation. Suppose I'm organizing the examination, the self-concept tool for the 50 mark, the maximum score is 50 mark, for example. But I am organizing the self-concept tool for the 50 students. From this average is 40. The average mark of the entire group is 40. The standard deviation is 5. The standard deviation of the entire group is 5. Then I may divide the group into three groups. How, in the sense, you can, the mean is 40, the standard deviation 5, no, I already mentioned. Therefore, 40, that is the formula is called mean plus or minus standard deviation. Therefore, mean plus standard deviation, 40 plus 5 is equal to 45. Those who are getting the scores more than 45, they are treated as a positive self-concept. And I'm coming back to the mean minus standard deviation. So our mean score is 40, our standard deviation score is 5. So if you're going to 40 minus 5, the answer is 35. It means that those who are getting the mark less than 35, they're treated as a negative self-concept people. So I divide the peoples into two groups. One is called positive concept, those who are getting the scores more than 45. Those who are getting less than 35, they're treated as a negative self-concept. Those who are getting the in-between, no? For example, 36 to 44. That group people is called as a moderate self-concept people. So like this, we can divide any people's, particularly this kind of self-concept or self-esteem, into three categories with the use of statistical measurement. It's possible. Otherwise, some standard tools, they already give some kind of interpretation that those are gaining the scores more than this, they are treated as a positive. They are gaining the scores less than this, they are treated as a negative self-concept. So you can easy to classify the people like this. Is it okay, Pragana?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Sir.
Okay. Thank you. So in the case of self-concept, there is a positive as well as negative. In between moderate also, even we are talking about the personality, you know, introvert, extrovert. So introvert, extrovert, the two different here. But in between, there is a one more moderated is called as here. Moderate people is called as a ambivert. So every people we can divide into three domains. So every personality or every things, if you want to measure the people's personality or people's learning, even the learning process, we have to divide the people's into three in the classrooms. One is called gifted students, other one is called average student, the third one is called slow learners. So how the categorization may possible based on the scores, which they gain the examination. The same mode, if you want to measure any people of the personality or in the self-concept, we can easy to measure based on some of the tools or techniques. Then finally, we can divide the people into three groups, like low, moderate, high. That is possible according to the statistically. And see, in this case, just I'm going to show one image, then you can understand this image. Yes, see this case. So this is called ideal self. This is called ideal self, but it's a real self. See, the real self, the people look like this. His self-image like this. But when the person, when you watching, or if you believe that he's the six-pack people, he can do anything, he can be able to hold anything. Like this, if you're thinking this, and there is a mismatch between his real self as well as the ideal self. Therefore, this mismatch may lead some kind of anxiety, because he believes that he can do every work like the six-pack people, but he's not able to do. But when he's not able to do, generally what it comes for him, some kind of anxiety, some kind of frustration may lead. This frustration may reduce the poor self-esteem. See this case, so from this example you can understand it. See, just I'm going to write with this example. Sometimes it's like a self-confidence. It's okay. Self-confidence is okay. But the apple is like this. But we cannot be moved like this, no? Some people, it's like a cat here. So you can see some of the image like this. Here the cat, here's the tiger. So we are, that is called, what is superiority complex. That's here, knowingly or unknowingly, the particular color just me describe what is discussing the two things. One is called the inferiority complex as well as superiority complex too. See, it's real image like this. But he believed that he become like this. It's not possible to move like this. But there is a chance this apple may move like this. There is a chance. Okay. But what is the real self? This is the real self. This is called ideal self. What you're expecting. So he is not moved to this mode. Therefore, generally, there is a very big deviation happened between the real self and the ideal self. Therefore, it may lead some of the anxiety as well as distress. Then it may create some kind of personal disorder also. Just I'm going to highlight the same things with the images. For example, I am the ideal, the real self, I'm the assistant professor. Just I'm writing a scene. I'm the assistant professor of Department of Education. This is my real self. So I know who am I. My self-image, I am the eligible in the case of the assistant professor. Like this, I'm feeling. So what is my ambitions? What is my ambition? Suppose I like to go with as a VC. So my ambition that my wish is to move as a VC by chance. That is my ideal self. But see, when I'm applying for the next year as the vice chancellor, I won't get. When I'm applying the vice chancellor for the after 5 years also, I won't get. Because my real self, I'm eligible now as an only the assistant professor. Suppose I like to keep as an ideal self, I can keep only the associate professor only. So once I feel like I may move to the associate professor very soon, there is a possible I can move as associate professor very soon. You got clear? So when I think like this, just I'm removing this image, then once again I come back. For this exam, just I'm going to describe here. Just I'm as an assistant professor. Now I want to become as an associate professor. So what is the basic qualification for the associate professor? 8 years of experiences and the APS course. And parallel, you have to guide the PhD scholars. Some of the basic norms are there. So whether once I feel, I may become an associate professor. So my real self, my self-image is assistant professor only, but I'm able to move as associate professor very soon. So if you feel this ideal belief, ideal self, therefore there is a confidence may happen because very soon I may reach the target. I may reach the ideal self. What is my ambition? What is the mission? Very soon I may reach here. Therefore, there is a congruence may happen between the real self and the ideal self. This congruence, it may lead the good self-concept or good self-esteem. But in this example, now I am the assistant professor only, but I like to move as a VC. So is it possible to use the VC? Very soon it's not possible because for the VC, the minimum eligibility professorship 10 years. So after reaching the professor, you have to work for the 10 years. Then only you can become a professor, what is the vice chancellor. Therefore, now I don't have, if I dream, I'm becoming a vice chancellor, it's not possible within a 10 years, 15 years. I have to more than 16 or 17 years. Then only I become. But now I am applying for the associate vice chancellor regularly. Data application may deny it because I'm not eligible. Then what it happened immediately, some kind of fear, anxiety may happen. Oh, I'm not eligible. Like that, I may think. Then finally, it leads some kind of personality disorder to orient. Therefore, there should be a match between the real self as well as the ideal self. So what you are, parallelly, what you become, it should be somewhat match with each other, with two. So if you are matching with each other, messes well with each other, then the conflicts may happen. If it not match with each other, so a lot of deviation happened between the real self and ideal self, then some kind of issues may come. So just once again, I'm going to highlight the what is conflict exactly. A person ideal self may not be concerned. I already mentioned that it's not concerned with every time we modify. So now I believe that I may move associate professor very soon. Okay. After reaching the associate professor, I may think that I may go for the professor. That's correct. After the professor, I may think as a vice chancellor, it's not an issue, because there is a match between the real self and ideal self. It's a continuous series, neither. But now I'm an assistant professor. Now itself, I dream to become a vice chancellor. It's not be possible, because we can move to everything with the sequential order only. So that sequential order, if you have some lacunas, may happen. It may lead some kind of disorder. The person's ideal self may not be consistent, which with what actually happens in life and experience of the person. Hence, a difference may exist between the person's ideal self and actual experiences. This is called as an incongruence. In the case of the incongruence, it both should be a mismatch. When the person's ideal self and the actual experience are consistent, very similar, like this. A state of congruence exists. Rarely, if ever, does a total state of congruence exist. All people experiences a certain amount of incongruence, but because each one's that's called manasarchi. I don't know, in Malayalam we may use the term as a manasarchi. Okay, so in manasarchi, having the two or three manasarchi may be there, so it may be talking about different things. So one manasarchi may be talking about that you can treat him, other manasarchi don't do these things. Like this, the different manasarchi is giving the different opinion. It may disturb our thought talking, and also that same thing is called as ideal self and real self. The real self is who you are now. So we have direct self image. So that self image, it matches with your ideal self. So that congruence may happen. So that close match may happen. Therefore, there is no issues in your self extremes as a self concept. But there is a mismatch between the ideal self and real self. Then the anxiety may arise. That anxiety may disturb your personality and all. So the same thing only. So here the incongruency, because lot of difference between the real self and ideal self. But here is moving towards the congruence. This is an example. See, once again, the ideal self as with the real self. The ideal self, what you became, and real self, what you are now. So these two things very near to each other. You have the good self-esteem. You have the good self-esteem. But your ideal self, what your ambition, what your goal, it is not matched or messed with the real self, then you are getting the poor self-esteem. So even good or bad are very high self-esteem, very low self-esteem. Like this, we can use a different terms also. And his theory is also highlighting the other things also. The basic human needs, no? The two things he is focusing on is the self-actualization, other one is called positive regards. So for reaching these two things, we have some kind of responses. One is called conditional response, other one is called unconditional responses. So in the case of the unconditional response, like without expectation. Without expectation, you are sharing your love and affection, or without expecting something from us, they are showing their own loves and all. That is called unconditional, without expectation. That is called unconditional love. That increases the self-actualization. But in the case of the conditional positive regards, like a give-and-take policy, so once you go with the given tech policy love things, only the self-discrimination may arise. This theory little extended, and the Carl Rogers person-centered perspective, you know, he highlighted the things. He believed that all the peoples are basically good. And he compared the peoples, the growth of the people into the oak tree. So he compared the people with the oak tree. According to him, the oak tree growth, no, it may happen with the three things. One is called water, sun, and nutrition. The three things may influence the growth of the oak tree. Similarly, the people's growth may depend on the three things that I already mentioned while starting my presentation. One is called genuineness, acceptance, and empathy. So for the growth of the people, it depends on the three characteristics. One is called genuineness, acceptance, empathy. And these three things I may highlight one by one now. So in the case of the, once again, I'm going to highlight the, what is my genuineness, or you what is, you know, the meaning of genuineness. Here, the genuine people, the people should show the honesty, the direct, they won't be show their facade and all. So they won't much focusing on themselves. They are, that people are very neutral people, they call as genuine people. The acceptance, here the acceptance, they're talking only the unconditional, not in the conditional love. Acknowledging feeling, even the problems, without pausing judgment, honoring and not devolving, without expecting. from others. That is called unconditional love. In the case of the empathy, turning that she knows the difference between sympathy and all empathy, difference between sympathy and empathy. But in the case of the, it's not talking about the sympathy. It's not talking about sympathy. It's talking about the how you are turning into the feeling of others, how we are perceiving the feeling of others, and how we are reacting the same manner you are reacting. That is called as a empathy is described here. So for growth of the people, it depends on the three things: genuineness, unconditional love, as well the empathy. Simple look like here, the trees grow, water, nutrition, and light facilities. And see what is the genuineness. So in the case of genuineness, we should the people may be very open in all the aspects, dropping their own facade and being transparent. They are very transparent in all the aspects. And the second one is called acceptance. In the case of the acceptance, here he highlight only the unconditional love. So the unconditional love represent without expecting, you are showing your love and affection. So other that is called as unconditional. See, here I'm talking about the conditional as well as the unconditional positive. Here the unconditional means warmth, acceptance, love that others shows you regardless of your behavior. So they are not expecting, here there is no give and take policy. So normally the unconditional love may happen between the parents, mothers, no, always they love the children without expecting anything. But as a children, we are expecting something from the parent, then only we are responding properly, okay? So wherever you are finding the love and affection, like a give and take policy basis, then it's called as a conditional. The positive requests we receive, if you behave a certain accepted ways. So suppose if you did something, then only the people may have done something. So that is called as a unconditional love. So conditional love. So without expecting something, someone's helping you, that is called unconditional. Unconditional. Just I'm giving some example of the unconditional positive regards. So there is a small example I'm listed here. The Vijay was thinking about becoming a maths teacher. He's a son of the parents. So he became a maths teacher or a computer or elementary school teacher. While Vijay's parents had told him that what he wanted to become was up to his wish. So in this matter, the parents won't be interfering in it. Therefore, he had the rights to select his own professional things. Suppose the parents are forcing to go with IAS or the medical doctor, but he's not have that much of quality to become a IAS officer or a doctor, automatically he feels that he's not able to satisfy the parents' needs, then anxieties may arise, that anxiety may disturb the personality and all. Therefore, here the parents not expecting anything from the children. So the parents are giving him much freedom to select his own profession. That's why he's selecting his profession, which he became max teacher and all. He don't like to satisfy it because the parents not expecting anything from him. But in the case of the conditional positive regard, there's another example. Ravi's news that he was becoming a doctor. So he sees it, he's not decided. He knew that he was becoming a doctor because the Ravi's parents had made it very clear to him as a small child onwards, he expected to become a doctor. So they forced that you should be become a doctor like this. The parents are believe the dreams. Suppose the children, that Ravi cannot be able to fulfill their dreams, no? Automatically some kind of frustration or fears may come. That fear may affect the closeness of the parents and the children. So that is called as a conditional. So there is a give and take policy basis for condition. Without expecting something, if you're sharing our love and affection to others, or some people are sharing the love and affection to us without expecting anything, then it's called as unconditional. Then one more characteristics in the case of the people's love, that is called empathy. The empathy means listening, sharing, and understanding. This term is very much important. Mirroring feel. It's the mirroring feel. So they're reflecting their meanings. So all together is called as empathy. So for seeing the people, for feeling, it's not a empathy. Then how we are helping to them, that is, it's called as the empathy. That's called as empathy. So one minute. Madam, this bill you can give to the Ashwini.
Feeling is the fundamental.
pen drive. Okay. Thank you, ma'am. So I will give to you. Thank you. Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, sorry. Just I'm going to leave my presentation. Then I'll come for the conclusion. They're evaluating the humanist first altogether. So I'm going to evaluate both the that Carl Rogers as well as the Maslow theory. So their contributions much focus on self-perceptions of the people's personality, and more or less they're talking about the positive experience of the human people, and it's emphasis the conscious experiences what they gain from them. What is the biggest criticism here happen fighting the humanistic approach? It's to be too optimistic. Yeah, the theory is focusing too optimistic, as well as it promotes the self-love, even the everything self-esteem, self-concept, everything's focusing on the narcissism based, looking only the self motivation as self development one. So that is the problem, the case of the humanistic approach. I'm going to come for the conclusion about this theory. I'm going to summarize here. For the Rogers, a person who is the process of self actualization, actually exploring the potential and the ability and experiencing to match between the real and ideal self. Is called as a full, he's defined one more term, who is called as a full functioning person in the sense. There is a match, it's happened between the real self and the ideal self. So that people, they're called as full functioning people, and that people's only they may reach a self-actualization, according to the Carl Rogers. And therefore, there is a match or the concrete may happen between the two selves. And the fully functioning people are in touch with their own feelings, the abilities, and are able to trust their innermost adjacent intuitions. To become the fully functioning, a person needs unconditioned. That's another term he is using. If you want to become a self-actualization people or in a fully functioning people, you should have the unconditional positive thoughts. Unconditioned, not in a conditional positive thoughts. So these two things, what is ideal self and real self, should be matched parallelly. The people having the unconditional people, they become a self-actualization, and self-actualization, they highlight the three terms. One is for genuineness, then acceptance is nothing but unconditional love, then other one is called as is empathy. So these three things may lead the people growth. That growth, it may reach the self-actualization, according to the Carl Rogers. So thank you. If you have any questions now, you can ask me now.